This is how much we did yesterday.
In this video, I wanna show you the actual winning product, how I set up the ads for this product, the video I used for this product, and everything you need to know about scaling this product. Good morning, beautiful people tuning in from Hawaii, here with another video for you guys. Let's go ahead and hop on my laptop and let me show you how you can also find your own winning products and scale it. Then I'll show you the profit and everything you need to know, because I know that's going to be the question. But Naz, how much is the profit? I'll show you all about it. All right, guys, here we are on my laptop. Let me first of all show you, this is about today. So today's silver, it's about two. So we're not really scaling. We're gradually scaling this product. So I'm gonna assume we're gonna hit maybe 2000 for today, but yesterday we did about 1673.91. And let me go ahead and show you the product. I talked about this product on my last videos. It was this hair curler. I actually showed you how to make a video for this product. So if you're interested, go check out that other video that I have about how to make creatives for TikTok ads. So go ahead and check it out. And now let's get into it. I'm sure the first thing everybody wants to know is how much is the profit? It's been kind of crazy because the profit is being crazy high. For that it is. For yesterday, it was about 38%. So keep in mind, I'm selling this product all in the UK and in the US. So with TikTok ads, my profit margin being crazy. Compared to Facebook, I usually have anything between 15 to 20% if I'm lucky. With TikTok, it's been anything between 30 to 40% profit margin, which is insane. Actually, recently I got a message from someone that was scaling your product and their profit margin was $60. They had this product, getting it for $2, selling it for like 30 bucks, which is kind of insane. So here we are. This is our profit margin. This is our ad spend for yesterday and the cost of goods and everything that you need to know about my yesterday. Probably one of the things I wanna know, how the creatives look like. I have another video actually making videos for this product. Like I said, if you wanna check it out, go ahead and check it out. But I made a couple videos for this, but this specifically ended up being better than the other products. So let's take a look at the actual winning video for this product.
What are products I've seen on the internet?
So in the beginning, you might notice that I said first TikTok, but then I noticed TikTok doesn't like it when you say products I found on TikTok, you get rejected. So don't say that. I had to re-edit everything and then change the voiceover after.
How do you set up the temperature and how long you want to curl your hair and everything that you need to get perfect curls?
Now let's try out this product and see if it actually works or not. We're gonna give it some time.
That's kind of an experiment I wanted to do to see if I can scale my own videos. I've done it before, just wanted to do it more.
Alright guys, if you're interested in getting this product, I put the link down below and go ahead and order yours.
So these kind of videos do really, really well on TikTok. I also noticed that the Siri voice or the Google voice or whatever that is also does really, really good on TikTok. And keep in mind, I originally tested this product. Actually, I ended up scaling this product with another video, which was just contents on the internet. And this is just what I'm testing with my own video. I wanted to see how far I can scale it and how far I can get it up there. For the last 2-3 days, since I've been starting to test it, not really scaling it, I've been doing 1 to 2,000 a day. Just kind of wanted to show you guys the beginning stages of how it looks like to scale, kind of figuring out what works and what doesn't. I've been also on a vacation, so I haven't been really talking to my team or figuring things out with the ads. Hopefully tomorrow when I get back home, I'm gonna start focusing more on scaling this product and see how far we can scale this product. If you want me to make a video on scaling this product, make sure that you put a comment down below and let me know. And of course, don't ever forget to push the like button. One thing that everybody's gonna ask is how did I set up my ads? So let's get on my ad account on TikTok and I'm gonna show you exactly how I do it. So if you notice here, no T is no targeting. And as crazy as it sounds, I usually used to pick just TikTok, but I've been testing it a little bit with automatic. Even though all my sales are coming from TikTok, for some reason, automatic been doing much, much better than just setting my placement as TikTok. Kind of weird, but let me show you exactly what's going on. This is yesterday. If you guys look at this, let's go from the beginning. You see we spent about $449. The cost per click is about 19 cents is the average. CPM, as you can see, $2.99, $4.10, $4.23. That's the average. The highest has been about $6.43, which honestly, with Facebook, my average winning product has about $10 cost per CPM. CPM is cost per 1,000 impressions. And then scrolling here, I also noticed with TikTok, if a product is a winning product, my average is anything over 2%. So I know I have some of them that are lower, but usually the average is around 2%. So my rule is if the product that you're testing is getting under 1.5% click-through rate, then that's possibly not gonna be a winning product. Personally, every winning product that I've had on TikTok, they had over 2% click-through rate. So that's the number I usually look for. Now, a lot of people ask, what do you look for CPC and CPM? CPC for me, again, most of my winning products are around 20 cents and less. Again, I don't wanna say necessarily, just based on my experience in the last couple months that I've been running TikTok ads, I've seen all the winning products have around 20 cents or less cost per click. So I always tell people look for anything under 50 just in case, you know, it might happen. With CPM, average been about $4 to $5. So that's like what I'm looking for. So if I get a product and the CPM is like $10, $12, I don't even bother with it. I kill it. I don't really let it spend money. I just kill it after maybe like $20 spent in the whole campaign. So now that we took a look at that, if you scroll down here, you see we're getting sales on these, and then you see the CPA, cost per acquisition. This one is a little bit high, 12, 13, 10. And then if you scroll all the way here, cost per complete purchase about $14.99. It's a little bit higher than usual. Again, the sale, 12,778, I think. That's probably because it didn't track. Yeah, it didn't track a bunch of the sales. So this is just how it is with TikTok. The same thing with Facebook. You're gonna get a bunch of sales that is not gonna be tracked on here. Now, again, gonna ask, how did I set up my ads? Literally, this is how I test them and how I'm been scaling them. But I'm gonna tell you what I do differently. I usually test setting the bid and then put everything in a CBO campaign. This been insanely good for me and does really, really well. Every time that I test with CBO, it doesn't really do well because it kind of blows up your money. You know, it just literally spends all your money. And even if you don't have a winning product, it just blows up your money. But here, what I usually do, this is literally the setup of all my ads on the back end. I don't choose any targeting. People think I'm crazy, but every time that I choose any targeting, my ads don't perform well. So I just choose no targeting. Doesn't matter if your pixel is seasoned or not. Don't worry about that. There's no such a thing. All right, so scrolling down, I always optimize for complete payment. I put the placement for automatic. Honestly, it doesn't really matter if you pick TikTok or select the placement. I personally notice automatic, the cost per purchase is a little bit lower, or I should say cost per acquisition. I turn this off, I keep this one on. I choose automated creative optimization. I usually test with anything between 2 to 4 videos to see which one does better. And usually after a couple of days, it tells you that which video is your highest performing and spends all the money on that one. This one actually tests everything apparently. It changes the text and the video, the image. So it kind of tests with different things to see which one delivers better and then kind of use that one. No targeting again. I've been testing with Canada and United States together. I scale a couple products, just setting it at US or Canada or having them separately. But I've been kind of messing around with Canada and US in the same one. So if I said before that I'm doing this split separately, that's because I was, but this also works. There's no one method that is better than the other one. If the product and the video is good enough to perform, it would perform no matter what you do. So don't worry so much about what method you're using. It's so much about your product and your video. All right, scrolling down, I do no limit. The age is from 18 and keep it open. Language, English, no targeting here. Scrolling down, yeah, I don't turn this on. And then for this one, actually, this is in a CBO campaign. But I usually, if you're just testing it, this is my scaling ad group. If you're testing, I would set my budget about $100 and I set the bid 10 and 15. So I would have multiple ad groups, 10, 15, 10, 15, and I do maybe sometimes 2 lowest cost just to see how they do. And if they do well, I put them all into a CBO campaign. I increase the budget to $200. Like this one is, I think this is a $200 campaign. Yeah, $200 campaign budget. And I have 5 ad groups inside. All the ad groups are identicals. The reason I do that, sometimes TikTok finds pockets of people that are better quality than the other ones. So it would just spend the money on the ones that are getting sales and the other one wouldn't do it. That's why one of the reasons I like CBO, because CBO would spend your money no matter what, right? Since you can't really set the bid, you have to do lowest cost. So I only set the CBO for when I know that I have a winning product, not for just testing. Like I said, with testing, it's kind of a waste of money. With CBO is when I want to scale and then see how it goes. And yeah, this is it. And I want to show you the product page real quick. This is a European store that I have. Like I said, I've been scaling it in Europe and the UK. In the UK, I've been selling it for $39.95. Should just go to sale. And then in the US, I think it's $49.95. I'm not sure, to be honest. I'm just going to show you the store real quick. This is the main landing page. My product page person usually follow the same kind of a pattern of putting product pages together, if that makes sense. So I kind of do the same things with all my product pages. Again, looking back here in the last, I guess, 4 days or 3 days, we did about 5,000, I think. But those are the days that I've been like, honestly, not even putting any effort. I've been out all about. And I like to scale my own ads, so I don't really have someone else to scale my ads. I have someone setting up my ads, but I like to scale them myself. So I haven't really put any effort into it. Tomorrow when I get back, I'm going to try to scale this product when I get back. So if you want me to make a video on that, make sure that you comment down below and I'll go ahead and make a video on that one too. All right, guys, thank you for watching. If you want me and my team help you find a winning product, scale your dropshipping store or any of that, make sure that you go on my Instagram. First of all, make sure you follow me, of course, follow your girl, and then go DM me, run my ads. My team will reach out, ask you a couple of questions to see if you're qualified to work with us, and then we'll go from there. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next video. Good morning, beautiful here.